Okay, let's look at how limits can be used to describe a function's behavior near its asymptotes. So of course, what we have here is our f of x equals 1 over x, our basic reciprocal function. And as we saw previously, it has two asymptotes. Got a horizontal asymptote, that's the x-axis, and a vertical asymptote, which is the y-axis. And remember the vertical asymptote is where the division by zero happens in this function. And the horizontal asymptote is really what the function is outputting as we get far, far right and far, far left. In this case, it would be outputting a y value of zero. So how can we describe this with limit notation? Well, in mathematics, there is something called limit notation. And of course, it's probably pretty obvious, L-I-M. And we have to say where x is going. And we're going to, of course, have a function inside our limit. So let's take a second to maybe look at how we would describe our this function's asymptotic behavior. It's horizontal asymptotic behavior. So what happens when our function x values get far, far right and approach positive infinity? Well, of course, these y values get closer and closer and closer to zero. So in our limit, we have to notate that x is getting really, really big. And if x gets really, really big, the function gets really, really close to zero. And with this limit notation, we're actually able to say that it equals zero. Similarly, on this side, if x gets really small and goes far, far, far left, then of course our function is still approaching zero. So the limit as x approaches negative infinity of f of x is also zero. So when you see x approaching positive or negative infinity, and you see a constant in this case, that should tell you that you're dealing with a horizontal asymptote. Of course, it's the same for a basic reciprocal function on both sides. Okay, now to the vertical asymptote. So if our x values get close and close to zero from the right-hand side, our function is skyrocketing. And it's outputting really, really, really big values, positive infinity. And pick a color here. How about green? If x is approaching zero from the left-hand side, tiny, tiny little negatives, our function is outputting really, really small values. Of course, we would say it's plummeting towards negative infinity. So here we can summarize our function's vertical asymptote behavior. Using limits and finish this off. So the limit as x approaches zero is going to be positive infinity when we approach zero from the right, and the notation for indicating that x is approaching zero from the right, small little tiny positive values, is a little plus up in the area where it typically would be an exponent. And the limit as x approaches zero from the left, I guess I use green here, so let's keep it intact. We put a little negative up where you would expect an exponent to be, and that's to indicate that x is approaching zero from the left through little tiny negative values. And if that happens, this function equals negative infinity. So to be clear here, our output of using this limit notation, the output of our function is going to be approaching positive or negative infinity, and of course that's describing vertical asymptotic behavior in both of these cases. Okay, and if x approaches infinity or negative infinity, that's what x is doing. And if you see a constant in terms of what this function is approaching, of course that is a horizontal asymptote.